I wanted to attempt the world record for the longest ice bath, but this could be incredibly dangerous if done wrong. So before I tried this, I needed to learn to become extremely tolerant to cold in just a few days. And there are several secrets that I discovered to help, with the first being an ancient breathing technique. It's called tumul breathing, or the breath of fire. It's easy to learn, but really hard to master. However, if you do it right, it's said to be able to raise your body temperature in a way that people used to think was impossible. And I'll show you how to do it, but before I do, I needed to take it to another level to try it out for myself. Since it helps you feel warm in the cold, I needed to go to the coldest place I could think of. Now you might think what I'm about to do is dangerous, which to the untrained person it can be. However, I believe we're capable of a lot more than we think, so I prepared myself in every way possible for this next challenge. And so in the freezing cold, I began to climb to the top of a mountain shirtless and in just shorts. I wanted to see what would happen to my body, and of course practice the breath of fire once I got to the top. After about 10 minutes, my skin started to go numb. The sun was coming out, however it was still really cold and I could even see my breath. And about a quarter way up the mountain, the numbness was spreading to my face.
Alright, I'm starting to go really numb, and I can feel it in my face. It's like harder to talk because my lips are going numb, but I'm gonna keep going. We're gonna make it to the top.
As I got higher, the temperature dropped, and I knew the very top of the mountain would be freezing. My skin was red and I had goosebumps everywhere, but after half an hour, I finally made it. Now that I was finally at the top, it was time to finally put the breathing into practice. So before I move on to the next step, let me explain how to do it, because it's incredibly useful. It simply starts out by taking 4 huge deep breaths in, then holding your breath while contracting your abdomen and pelvic floor muscles. But there's one more part which is super important, but didn't really make sense to me why. But I'll get into that in a second. Right now, I was almost ready for the ice bath. I just needed to do one thing first. What I'm doing here is filling up a small bucket of ice water for me to put my hands in. This is a standard pain tolerance test, and previously I tried and lasted 13 minutes. But after 30 seconds, it started to hurt.
It's starting to go numb.
However, I wanted to see if with my training, I could push myself for longer. After beating my record, the ice was actually starting to melt. I kept going for as long as possible, but in the end, something happened that I didn't expect.
All right, it's been almost 25 minutes, and I've run out of ice. I'm gonna go out, get more ice, and get ready to do the actual ice bath.
Remember how I said there was one more step to the breathing exercise that didn't make much sense to me? Well, that step is simply visualizing a fire within you. So as I was warming up and getting ready for the ice bath, I was thinking about how powerful the mind is, that simply thinking about the heat can actually warm you up. By this point, I felt prepared and I knew that something amazing was gonna happen whether or not I broke the record.
Pretty cold.
This time, instead of using a couple handfuls of ice, I was gonna use 15 bags. I needed to make sure that however long I lasted, the ice would always be there. This needed to be as cold as possible. Now, the reason I'm doing this is to train my mind to be able to handle anything that comes my way, to become mentally invincible. But the interesting thing is what immediately happened to my body. As you can see, I started to hyperventilate. It was immediately freezing, and after just 2 minutes, I encountered a problem.
What's happening?
Training.
I was training out there, I think. I don't know. That's annoying.
However, I wanted to go as long as possible, so I started to use what I'd learned.
Okay, so it's been less than 4 minutes, and I've kind of started to go numb. I'm gonna start focusing on my tumul breathing, and then we're gonna try a strategy in just a second.
The world record that I have to beat is over 2 hours and 45 minutes. My personal record is 33, but that had pushed me to my limit. However, I had another idea that I wanted to try.
I left some cloths for you. You can go get, say, 2 of them right now to start, and run them under, like, warm water. I'm gonna hold one of them with my hands, then you'll put the other one on my forehead.
This blew my mind. Apparently, we have special blood vessels in our hands, feet, and face which control our core body temperature.
I really wish there was more water in here. I don't know why it drained.
So I wondered if I held something warm, it would help.
I could feel like in my pinky, it's starting to go kind of cold and numb, even though it's not even in the water.
And surprisingly, I think the cloths really did help. However, here's where things started to get much harder. They say you should never stay in an ice bath longer than 15 minutes, or you run the risk of getting hypothermia. I hadn't even beat my record yet, and I was already in the danger zone. But yet, we added more ice to make it even colder. I really had to make sure I was careful.
What's the time?
35:07.
I've officially beat my record.
I'd beaten my record, but I still wanted to keep pushing despite feeling horrible. And after 40 minutes, we checked for hypothermia symptoms.
Shivering.
Oh, I'm shivering.
Exhaustion.
I'm not that yet.
Confusion.
No.
Fumbling hand.
No.
Memory loss.
No.
Slurred speech.
I don't think I'm slurring my speech.
Drowsiness.
No.
I figured I didn't have hypothermia, so I kept pushing on.
This might surprise you, but it's actually gonna get a lot worse after I get out.
You'll see what I mean, but at this point, I was starting to feel sick, and I just wanted to make it to an hour. And I was not ready for what was about to happen.
There you go, that's 1 hour in the bath.
You can get out, Tyler.
You would think that getting out of an ice bath after being in there for an hour would feel super nice. However, I was stiff and I couldn't feel my body.
I can't feel anything.
Just getting out though wasn't the hard part. I was completely numb and just struggling to move. It felt like all my muscles were frozen, but as I started to warm up, it started to get painful. I really didn't expect it to be this bad, but I knew I had to push through. I was at least happy that I almost doubled my previous record.
Ah, it hurts. Oh.
Good. good, homie?
Yeah. All right, I've warmed up to room temperature.
But of course, in the spirit of becoming mentally invincible, the next thing I'm gonna have to do is overcome some of my biggest fears.